In 2009, Adam Lambert took American Idol by storm, coming in second place on the show's eighth season. However, Lambert's style rubbed Idol judge Simon Cowell the wrong way at first. Here's a peek inside Adam Lambert's relationship with Simon Cowell. Adam Lambert and Simon Cowell's relationship has sometimes been iffy. In a June 2018 interview with NME, Lambert said he felt mistreated by Simon on Idol because of his identity, and he wasn't the only one, Lambert explained. Up until my season, anytime someone came on the show that was perceived to be gay, or it was obvious enough that they were gay, they were a joke. They were made fun of. Simon would make fun of them. Since then, times have changed, and Lambert and Cowell are on better terms, as Lambert told NME. I did the finale the year before last, and it was the first time I had seen him in 10 years. He was sweet. He said, "Good to see you, good job." He sort of wised up on that angle, and he realized quickly, that is not acceptable anymore. Lambert's somewhat direct criticism of Cowell, however, was a bit of a left turn from his remarks in the past. Simon Cowell and Adam Lambert first met each other during Lambert's American Idol audition when he performed Queen's Bohemian Rhapsody. While Lambert was belting his heart out, Cowell cut the audition off early, then chimed in.
I'm going to give you my opinion for what it's worth. I think you are theatrical.
Not exactly a ringing endorsement. When asked by his fellow judges if he thought Lambert was a good singer, Cowell seemed to agree, although he was hesitant to provide too much confirmation. He did, however, give Lambert that all-important yes to progress to the next round. However, Lambert's talent and star quality quickly showed through. During an interview with Splash News, Cowell was asked who his favorite contestant on the eighth season of American Idol was so far. He replied, "I think this guy, Adam." By the time the finals rolled around, Cowell predicted Lambert would win the whole thing. Lambert, of course, did not win Idol, but it didn't matter. He went on to great success, proving that Cowell knows a star when he sees one. Simon Cowell received his star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame on August 22, 2018. In typical Cowell fashion, he kept his speech as real as possible.
"Why has this taken so long? I'm kidding."
Cowell continued, "If anyone says fame is a bad thing, I don't know what you're talking about. It's the best thing in the world." The first winner of American Idol, Kelly Clarkson, was on hand to celebrate with her former mentor. During her remarks at the event, she said of Cowell, "He's the best friend you can ever have. He's honest and supportive. Simon appreciates authenticity, even if it's not something he's into. He appreciates you being yourself. That's very rare in this industry." Adam Lambert, who was also in attendance, congratulated the legendary American Idol judge on his big day and tweeted, "Congrats on your Walk of Fame star, Simon Cowell. Thank you for your honesty and for helping kickstart my career in the music industry." On January 11, 2010, Simon Cowell announced that his ninth season as a judge on American Idol would be his last. During the Television Critics Association press tour, Cowell discussed his decision to leave the show to launch the American version of The X Factor. Cowell explained, "I want to leave Idol this year bigger and better than it was in the past. I didn't think it was right to do two shows in America at the same time, so I decided to leave one and start another." Cowell leaving the show left a void that could never be filled. In an interview with Oprah, Adam Lambert explained why. "The audience will definitely miss Simon. The contestants will miss out on, like, really honest criticism. Sometimes it can be a little personal, and I know other contestants took it to heart sometimes and got really stressed out about what he would say, but I think that that's important to making you a better performer. You've got to hear the good and the bad." In a 2002 interview with the Los Angeles Times, Simon Cowell explained his iconic American Idol judging style. He said, "I'm not there to stop someone from chasing their dream. If they believe they are great, good luck to them. But if they come to our audition and they want to be told the truth, they will be told." Adam Lambert credited Cowell's truths for preparing for the music industry and fame, and told The Sun in 2018, "Simon really supported me. He was amazing. I mean, he even gave me the tough love that I needed as well. Simon is known as Mr. Nasty. He's the guy that is going to tell you the truth. He wants to see if you can hang as an artist, as this industry is brutal, and the public is even worse." Speaking with Oprah in 2012, Lambert recalled why finally getting Cowell's endorsement meant so much to him, as he explained.
"I feel like I could trust him because he is so hard on the contestants." Yeah.
It seems American Idol has come a long way since Simon Cowell and Adam Lambert first graced our screens. In 2020, Idol found its first openly gay winner in Samantha Diaz. who goes by the stage name Just Sam, and it only took 18 seasons. Diaz told New York Post, "I am a child of God, so that's always going to be first. That's actually the only label that I ever want to have. But I like what I like, and that's just that, you know? And it's not men, like, at all." As the judges' chairs have shuffled, the treatment of contestants has changed for the better. Like with the first drag queen finalist, Ada Vox. Vox made it to the top 10 in 2018, even without securing enough votes, as the judges, with particular encouragement from Katy Perry, pushed her through to the next round. Vox told Billboard, "I must say that Katy Perry was one that I kind of had to convince from the beginning that I was more than just some shtick or gimmick. The fact that she came around so quickly, it really meant a lot to me, especially from someone who is so relevant in the industry today. Thankfully, it seems the show has become more accepting and supportive, especially of LGBTQ+ contestants in recent years." Check out one of our newest videos right here. Plus, even more Nicki Swift videos about your favorite celebrities are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.